Welcome to Science Tour online classes.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Dear students, welcome back to Biology online classes. The CET and NEET topic what we are discussing is all about the chapter Morphology of Flowering Plants. Take out the next worksheet under this particular chapter, that is worksheet number 2. So there are about 50 questions to be discussed. In one session we will discuss around 25 questions. Then in another session 25 more questions we are going to discuss. We have already completed the first worksheet. Now in this worksheet, let me read out the first question for you. That is question number 1. Primary root is the direct elongation of. Primary root is from 1, whether it is pedicel or radical or plumule or stamen. Now the primary root, which is directly, it is elongation of radical of the seed. It is radical of the seed. That is option 2. Now if you see the option 1, they have given pedicel. What is a pedicel? Pedicel is nothing but the stalk of the flower. The stalk of the flower is called as pedicel. Now what is plumule? Plumule is nothing but the part of the embryo which gives the shoot system. It gives the shoot system. Then stamens. Stamens are the male reproductive organs. The male reproductive organs, they are called as the stamens. Coming to question number 2, the type of root present in mustard plant is, mustard plant nalli yava type idu root present unto. 1. Fibrous roots. 2nd one adventitious roots. 3rd one tap roots. 4th one nodulated roots. Mustard is a dicot. So characteristic feature of dicots is presence of tap root. So what is a tap root, students? The tap root is the root which directly develops from the radical of the seed. Now fibrous root means here in case of the tap root, there is a primary root which directly arises from the radical of the seed, and the from the primary root arises the lateral branches which forms the secondary root, and once again from the secondary root the lateral branches arises which forms the part of the tertiary root. So that is the correct option, that is option 3. Now fibrous root means here it also arises from the radical, but the primary root is very short lived and it is replaced by a bunch of roots which arises from a single point, okay, and it forms the fibrous root. Then the adventitious roots which develops from the part other than the radical, it is called as adventitious roots. Nodulated roots means it is also a type of adventitious roots where you can find some nodules like structures in this. So mainly you can see in some of the leguminous plants, so nodules, root nodules are present. Next, move to question number 3. Which of the following is not the lateral branches of the roots? Which is not a lateral branch of the root? tertiary root is a lateral branch. I said secondary roots also a lateral branch. Primary root is not a lateral branch. It is the main root which directly develops from the radical of the seed. Then more than one option is not correct. Only one option is correct, that is the option 3. Next, question number 4. In wheat plant, dash root system is present. Wheat plant nalli yava root system present agide. Then one nodulated root, second one tap root, 3 fibrous root, and fourth one prop root. Yes. In wheat plant, presence of fibrous root is there because it is a monocot. Tap root you can see in case of dicots. Not a nodulated root, nor a proper root, not a prop root. Prop root you can see in case of banyan tree, Aladamara, that is Ficus bengalensis. And this prop root is a aerial root modification which helps for providing mechanical support. So there are lateral branches arises from the stem, and from the lateral branches arises the roots which grows downwards towards the earth surface, touches the soil, and provides mechanical support to the large and stout stem, such as in case of banyan tree. Question number 5. Which of the following is not the main function of the root system? Ee kelaginagalalli root system idu main function yavudalla. 1. It provides anchorage to the plant or plant parts. Yes, it provides anchorage. Then synthesize the PGRs, means plant growth regulators. Which are the plant growth regulators? The plant growth hormones you are going to study in chapter number 15, plant growth hormones. Okay, auxins, gibberellins, cytokinins, then ethylene, then abscisic acid. So plant growth regulators, they may be promoters or they may stop the growth or inhibitors. Next, absorption of water and minerals from the soil. Yes, it is the function of the root only, but it will not perform any photosynthesis because they don't have any pigment to perform the photosynthesis. So that is the incorrect option, option 4. Let's move to the next question, question number 6. A root grows in length. Which region of the root is responsible for the growth? Andre lengthwise grow aglike, which region of the root is responsible? Whether it is root cap or region of meristematic activity or region of elongation or region of maturation. So the root cap is the region which protects the root tip. Region of meristematic activity means which contains rapidly dividing cells and which helps for the rapid growth of the plant parts. Region of elongation means which responsible for the lengthwise growth of the root. It is not region of maturation. Region of maturation is the region where the root hairs starts to appear, and these root hairs helps for the absorption of water and minerals from the surrounding soil. Let's move to question number 7. Root hairs are present in or on? Yes, region of elongation, region of maturation, region of meristematic activity, or root cap. Yes, this is the answer, is region of maturation. Root hairs are present the region of maturation. Then the region or part of the root that increases the surface area for water absorption is, which region or the part of the root increases the surface area for water absorption. You are correct, that is the root hair, the root cap, which gives protection to the young tip of the root. Zone of elongation helps to increase the lengthwise growth of the root. Then meristematic zone means which is involved in growth, rapid growth of the root. So root hairs are the region which helps for absorption of water and the minerals. Coming to question number 9, the tap roots of dash gets modified to store food. Which tap root modified? Carrot, onion, ginger, sweet potato. Yes, the roots of carrot, it is modified to store the food. Onion alli stem modification irudu. Then stem or leaf modification irudu. Ginger underground stem modification. Sweet potato, it is, once again, sweet potato, it is not tap root, it is the adventitious root. So in carrot you can see the conical root, which is broad at the top and tapering towards the tip. So scientific name of the carrot is Daucus carota. You have already studied. So here the tap root is directly modified. Then onion, it is a stem modification. They have disc shaped stem, or they have leaf modification, scaly leaves, which are helpful for storing of food material. The scientific name of the onion is Allium sepa. What is that? Allium sepa. Then coming to the ginger. Ginger is once again the underground stem modification. The scientific name of the ginger is Gingiber officinale. Sweet potato, scientific name is Ipomoea batatus. So this sweet potato helps for storage of food only, but it is adventitious roots are modified, not the tap roots. So that cannot be a right answer. So the right answer is the option 1. Let's move to the next question. Adventitious roots of dash get swollen and store food. Whether it is carrot, or whether it is turnip, or radish, or sweet potato, adventitious roots of dash gets swollen and store food. So adventitious roots of dash, come on, just now I told, that is sweet potato, that is Ipomoea batatas, radish, fusiform root. What is a fusiform root? The both the ends are tapering but broad at the middle. Raphanus sativus, that is the scientific name of the radish. Then comes the turnip. Turnip is the scientific name, you know, Brassica rapa, you know, Brassica rapa. So this turnip, Navilkosu in Kannada, so it is broad at the top and suddenly tapering towards the base, correct? So that is modification of a tap root. Carrot nalli kuda tap root modification, but in sweet potato it is the adventitious roots which are modified. Question number 11, supporting roots coming out of the lower nodes of the sugarcane stem are, supporting roots which comes from the lower nodes of the sugarcane, they are called as, yes students, you are correct, it is the stilt root. Okay, example in case of sugarcane, the scientific name is Saccharum officinarum. Saccharum officinarum, other than this sugarcane, you can also give the example of pandanus. Another example is
pandanus for stilt root students.
Got my point? Next, prop root you can see in case of Ficus bengalensis, that is in case of banyan tree. Okay, nematophores. Nematophores means they are present in the plants which are living in marshy areas, Jaugu Pradesha. They are the halophytes. They can grow in the region where the salinity of the soil is high. So the soil contains less amount of oxygen. So they will grow upwards away from the soil. So they are positively geotrophic, these roots, and they are have pores. Those are called as lentils. And these pores helps for exchange of atmospheric gases or oxygen. So that is about the nematophores. You can see in case of the plants like Rhizophora, Candela, Avicennia, all these are mangrove vegetations. You can see in case of mangrove vegetation. Next, coming to the fusiform root, as I said, fusiform roots is nothing but broad at the middle and tapering towards the tip. You can see in case of radish, fusiform root. Raphanus sativus. What is the botanical name? Raphanus sativus. By repeating and repeating only, you can remember these botanical names. Next, coming to question number 11 or 12. In Rhizophora, roots are modified to form. Yes, just now I told. Nematophores. The right answer is nematophores. Tuberous roots you can see in case of sweet potato. Stilt root you can see in case of sugarcane or pandanus. And storage roots you can see in case of either tap roots or adventitious roots. Maybe tap roots like in case of carrot, conical root, radish, fusiform root, beetroot, that is nepiform root, or maybe adventitious roots like in case of asparagus, shatavari, or in case of dahlia, or in case of sweet potato. Coming to question number 13, the hanging structures that support the banyan tree are called, which are the hanging structures which support the banyan tree? Just I told, it is the prop roots, option 1, not the stilt root. Stilt root in sugarcane and pandanus, nematophores in case of mangrove vegetation, root hair cells for just absorption of water and minerals from the surrounding soil. Question number 14, stem develops from dash of the embryo of a germinating seed. Stem develops from plumule. Stem develops from plumule part of the embryo. Radical gives the roots. Radical gives the roots. Pedicel is nothing but the stalk of the flower. Peduncle is the stalk of the inflorescence. Nematophore are the breathing roots. You can see in case of mangroves. So the right option is the option 2, plumule. Question number 15. Dash are the regions of the stem that bear leaves. Which are the regions of the stem that bear leaves? Leaves, stems, which part appears? Whether from internode? No, it always arises from the nodes, not from the foliar bud. Foliar andre leaves, leaf bud ninda barudilla. It is not coming from the radical bud also, but it always appears from the nodes. Okay, so the regions of the stem that bear leaves are the nodes. Next, stem of potato, ginger and turmeric are modified to stem of potato. Potato scientific name is Solanum tuberosum, Solanaceae family. Ginger, gingiber officinale, Gingiberaceae family. Turmeric, Curcuma longa, it is also Gingiberaceae family. Ginger family only. These are all modified to what? Store the food. All examples for underground stem modification, correct? Not for respiration, neither for performing photosynthesis or nor for providing support, but to store the food. Moving to question number 17, in gourds, bitter gourd, pumpkins, watermelon, all belongs to gourd family, Cucurbitaceae family. The axillary buds develop spirally coiled structures. What are these spirally coiled structures which are present in the axils? These are called as tendrils. So tendrils helps to give support in case of the stem it is weak. Okay, now thorns are example for what modification? Stem modification. Example in case of citrus, bougainvillea, grapevine, correct? Thorns, these are the hard and woody pointed structures which are a modification of axillary bud. Offsets, offsets are subaerial modification of the stem. You can see in case of water plants like water hyacinth, Icornia, Jassia, Pistia, Nilumbo, Lotus, okay, Hydrilla. These are the aquatic plants in which you can see the subaerial modification of the stem. There is a horizontal stem with the short nodes and internodes, and from the nodal region arises rosettes, group of leaves, and from the base arises a bunch or group of the roots which are having air pockets. So they help to provide buoyancy or helps for floating of these plants. Suckers, suckers you can see in case of banana or chrysanthemum, sevantige hoo, pineapple, where there is a main stem which grows beneath the soil, and from the main stem only the lateral branches arises which grows horizontally to certain distance. Once again it will arches upwards and touches the soil, and from that region new plant will arise. This already I have explained in my synopsis class, that is the sucker. Okay, then dash protect the bougainvillea from grazing animals. Which protects bougainvillea from grazing animals? Yes, it is nothing but the modification of stem, that is stem thorn, which is a hard, woody and pointed structure. Axillary buds modified. Next, tendrils, yes, they provide support. Suckers and offset I already mentioned. Question number 19, stems are modified into flattened structures which carry out the photosynthesis in. Stems are the modified flattened structures which becomes green and photosynthetic. Okay, flat structures in case of opuntia, cactus, correct, or cylindrical in case of euphorbia, a type of weed plant. Okay, so it is called as phylloclade. The main axis having many nodes and internodes, and they show unlimited growth. There is one more structure I told, that is cladode or cladophyll. It is also a type of phylloclade, but here there are branches which are modified. The branches which are having limited growth and they are having only one or two internode length. They are grow up to one or two internode in their length. So that is in case of cladode or cladophyll. So cladode or cladophyll example, here asparagus, cladode or cladophyll example is, sorry, cladode or cladophyll, yes, example is asparagus. Or one more example is ruscus. This also I have discussed in my synopsis. Then, so the right option is option 2, opuntia. Euphorbia, it is not flattened stem, it is a cylindrical stem. Bougainvillea, it is the stem modification, that is called a stem thorn. And in Colocasia. Colocasia, it is also a stem modification, but it is the underground stem modification. Kesu. So underground stem modification, which helps for storage of the food. That is in case of Colocasia. Next question number 20. Chlorophyll containing fleshy cylindrical structures found in euphorbia are modified. Chlorophyll iruvantadu andre photosynthesis ide. Fleshy cylindrical structures found in euphorbia, they are modified. Just now I told they are the modified stem. They are not the modified leaves or fruits or roots, but they are the modified stem. Question number 21. In Pistia and Icornia, stems are modified to form Pistia, Icornia. Just now I told these are all examples for water plants, hydrophytes. So that is called as offset, option number 1, not the tendrils, nor they are stolons or the suckers. Let's move to question number 22. Leaves originate from dash and are arranged in dash order. Leaves, they are originate from the shoot apical meristem and are arranged in acropetal order. Leaves always arise from the shoot apical meristem. Shoot means gives the stem and their leaves. So stem is the node in the leaves birthday. So they are containing at the apical region rapidly dividing cells, which are called as meristematic tissue. So shoot apical meristem, and they are arranged in the acropetal order. Andre older leaves are arranged at the base and the younger leaves are arranged at the top. So that is in the acropetal manner. So the right option is option 3. Let's move to question number 23. Which of the following is not a part of the leaf? ಇವುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದು ಲೀಫ್ ಇದು ಒಂದು ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅನಾಕರಲ್ಲಿ. One pedicel, yes, pedicel is not a part of the leaf. It is the part of the flower. The stalk of the flower is called as pedicel. Leaf base, petiole, and leaf lamina. Petiole is the stalk of the leaf. Leaf lamina or leaf blade is the expanded part of the leaf, which contains veins and veinlets. Base is attached to the nodal region of the stem. Okay, so the leaf is attached to the nodal region of the stem by its base. Next, question number 24. Leaf base may bear two lateral small leaf-like structures. These are called as ಗೊತ್ತುಂಡಲ್ಲ ಲೀಫ್ ಬೇಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿರುವಂಥ ಪೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಇದೆ ಔಟರ್ ಲ್ಯಾಟರಲ್ ಔಟ್ ಗ್ರೋಸ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಸ್ಟಿಪ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಲೀವ್ಸ್ ವೆನ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಯಂಗ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್. ವೆನ್ ದ ಲೀವ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಬಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ದೇ ಪ್ರೊಟೆಕ್ಟ್ ದೀಸ್ ಲೀವ್ಸ್. ದೋಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಟಿಪ್ಯೂಲ್ಸ್. ಲೀಫ್ ಬ್ಲೇಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಲೀಫ್ ಬ್ಲೇಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಪೆಟಿಯೋಲ್ ಕೂಡ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ಲೆಮೈನಾ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಪಲ್ವಿನಸ್. So leaf base may be two lateral small leaf like structures, they are called as stipules. Lamina andre leaf blade expanded part, adha kelodu. Sepals andre calyx, the members of the calyx, outer worst accessory whorls of the flower, avugalige sepals helodu. They may be green color, okay, maybe gamosepals or polysepals, maybe fused sepals or maybe free sepals. Okay, pulvinous leaf base andre ಲೀಫ್ ಬೇಸ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಇದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸ್ವೋಲನ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಪಲ್ವಿನಸ್ ಲೀಫ್ ಬೇಸ್. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ಇನ್ ಕೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೆಬೇಸಿಯ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್, ಲೆಗ್ಯುಮಿನೇಸಿಯ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ, ಲೆಗ್ಯೂಮ್ಸ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ ನಂಬರ್ 25. ಸ್ವೋಲನ್ ಲೀಫ್ ಬೇಸ್ ಫೌಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ಲೆಗ್ಯುಮಿನಸ್ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್, ಒನ್ಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ದ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಷನ್, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಪಲ್ವಿನಸ್, ಆಪ್ಷನ್ 4. So students, we have completed up to question number 25. Let's move to question number 26. Which one of the following plants shows alternate phyllotaxy? Phyllotaxy under an arrangement of leaves and leaflets on the branches of the stem, that is called as phyllotaxy. Phyllo means leaves, taxis means arrangement of the leaves, that is the phyllotaxy. Okay, so phyllotaxy, that is alternate fill note tag. See alternate illi ondu nodalli ee mattond nodu illi this note this not opposite but alternate where see in case of sunflower see in case of sunflower that is option 1 what are the other examples for alternate phyllotaxy alternate type of phyllotaxy you can also seen in case of china rose and mustard apart from the sunflower world type of phyllotaxy can see in case of alstonia and macadamia what is that macadamia from macadamia plant which is having world phyllotaxy australian fruit cake can be prepared so this particular plant it is native to australia that is called as macadamia which is having world phyllotaxy then opposite phyllotaxy you can see in case of calotropis as well as in guava perale hannu okay nerium or oleander once again world phyllotaxy I explained calotropis and guava it is opposite phyllotaxy coming to question number 27 the petiole expand and become green to synthesize food in the petiole the stalk of the leaf it becomes expanded becomes green and photosynthetic that is called as a type of leaf modification it's called as phyllode it is called as phyllode and you can see in case of australian acacia ncrt question very important australian acacia venus flytrap is a insectivorous plant dionaea species which is a carnivorous insectivorous plants catch the insects and crush and absorb their nitrogen content nitrogen is very essential for the plants to for the normal or proper growth and development because these insectivorous plants they mainly grow in the region where there is a scarcity of nitrogen in the soil Pisum sativum it is the garden pea Fabaceae member ge barudu Solanum is belong to Solanaceae family so petiole expand and become green structure called as phyllode to synthesize the food in case of Australian acacia Moving to question number 28 mark the incorrect statement 1 flower is a modified shoot how do yaralla helidu yes it is correct it is a modified shoot in cymose inflorescence the main axis terminates in a flower and the flowers are open up in basipetal succession the younger are at the base and the older are at the top flowers are borne on successive internodes on the stem and roots no flowers are borne on successive nodes on the stem they not grow on the internodes so third option is the incorrect one what does the fourth option says when a shoot tip transforms into a flower the flower is always solitary correct shoot tip okay now when a shoot tip transforms into a flower shoot tip nalli flower iddare okay the flower is always solitary andre the flower is always single so it is a shoot tip the flower ide andre anskolva this flower is always a solitary means it is always a single it is not okay occurring in groups so it is always in single solitary single we'll move to the next question question number 29 the four whorls of a flower are arranged on naalku whorl ide adralli two outer whorls are called as the accessory whorls and the two inner whorls they are called as essential whorls the accessory whorls are called as the calyx the members of the calyx are called as sepals and the calyx between innondu adra valage iruvantadu inside the calyx there is what corolla and the members of the corolla are called as the petals similarly there are essential whorls like androecium and the members of the androeciums are called as stamens and gynoecium and the members of the gynoecium they are called as the carpels correct or pistils so they are all lie on a structure, a receptacle, and that is called as thalamus. So the right option is the option 1, thalamus. It is not a pedicel, it is not petiole. Petiole is the stalk of the leaf. Corolla means it is, I told, the members of corolla are called as petals, an accessory well. Stamens are male sex organs. Moving to question number 30. Radial symmetry is found in the flowers of. Radial symmetry andre enu? Actinomorphic. Then zygomorphic andre bilaterally symmetrical. And the third type is asymmetry, means there is no symmetry. So radial symmetry, when a plane of symmetry which passes through the central axis radially, or radial plane when passes through the central axis, divides the flower into equal halves from any radial plane, then but the it should pass through the central axis, then it is called as the radial symmetry or the actinomorphic. Adare zygomorphic andre eno, if through only one plane, that the vertical plane, if you which the vertical plane which passes through the central axis can divide the flower into two equal halves, such that the right half is the mirror image of the left half, then it is called as zygomorphic flower, or what? Bilaterally symmetrical flower. Correct? And any plane which passes through the central axis will not divide the flower into equal halves, then it is called as asymmetry. You can see in case of canna. Correct? Zygomorphic flower, you can give the example of pea, beans, gulmohar, isn't it? Okay. Then radial symmetry, you can see in case of beans. Sorry, radial symmetry, you can see in case of chili. Cassia, gulmohar, beans, grams, in all you can see the bilateral symmetry. Okay, then in case of mustard, chili and datura, you can see mustard, chili as well as datura, you can see the actinomorphic conditions. So chili, scientific name is capsicum annuum. So there is option 2, chili, mustard, mathe datura. In all the three you can see the radial symmetry. So the right answer is option 2. Let's move to question number 31. The flower of which of the flowering following plant is zygomorphic? Idalli yavudradu flower zygomorphic, just now I told it is beans, means bilaterally symmetrical. Datura zygomorphic. Allah, datura it is actinomorphic. Mustard it is actinomorphic. Canna it is asymmetrical. Then which of the following plants has a superior ovary? Yava plant is superior ovary ide? Whether it is peach, a guava, or China rose, or just a rose? Yes. Superior ovary means the flower should be hypogynous. Guava, it is having inferior ovary. Inferior ovary, so it is a epigynous flower. Peach and rose, it is perigynous, because the ovary is either half superior or half inferior. And China rose, it is a superior ovary because the flower is hypogynous. So there are three types of flowers: hypogynous flower, perigynous flower, and epigynous flower. Hypogynous flower only, the ovary is superior and all the different parts are arise from the base of the ovary. Inferior only, the ovary is the epigynous flowers only, the ovary is inferior and all the different whorls which are arising from the top of the ovary. Okay, and in from the middle portion, in case of when the ovary is half inferior or half superior, and when the flower is perigynous conditions, from the middle portion of this ovary in the different valves will develop. So plum, peach, rose examples for perigynous flower, guava, cucumber and ray florets of sunflower are example for inferior ovary, and the mustard, China rose and brinjal are examples for superior ovary. So the right option is option 3, that is China rose. Let's move to question number 33. Which of the following plant has epigynous flower? Adalli epigynous flower ide. 1 cucumber, 2 brinjal, 3 mustard, 4 peach. Cucumber has epigynous flower. Correct. Option 1. Question number 34. The ray florets of sunflower has 1 superior ovary, 2 half inferior ovary, 3 half superior ovary, 4 inferior ovary. Ray florets of sunflower has inferior ovary. So sunflower belongs to Asteraceae family. In Asteraceae family, there are two types of florets. The peripheral one called as ray florets. They are not exactly called as flowers, but smaller flowers, they are called as the ray florets. And the peripheral flowers, which are called as the ray florets, they are unisexual. That means they may be either male or female. And the florets, which are from at the middle, center, they are the disc florets, because they are bisexual. Since they are bisexual, they are having both the sex, that is male and female sex organs. So two types of florets are seen in case of Asteraceae member, that is sunflower, the outer ray florets and the middle or the center disc florets. Next, we'll move to question number 33. Which of the following plants has epigynous flower? Over. Okay. So that is cucumber, brinjal, mustard, peach. It is cucumber. They have epigynous flower. Cucumber, ray florets of sunflower. Plum, peach, rose. They are having perigynous flower. Chili, brinjal and mustard, they have hypogynous flower. Cucumber, ray florets of sunflower and guava, they are all having inferior ovary, that means epigynous flower. So all the questions what are discussed till now, it's very important, particularly in this worksheet. Okay. Next, the ray florets of sunflower has superior ovary, half inferior ovary, half superior ovary, inferior ovary. Yes. Third question number 34, it is inferior ovary. Next, question number 35, mark the incorrect match. Calotropis, valvate estivation, correct. Lady's finger, a twisted estivation, is correct. Cassia, it is not valvate, it is imbricate estivation. Gulmohar also, it is imbricate estivation. You know what are estivation? The arrangement of the different members of the whorl, within the whorl. Okay, the arrangement of the sepals or petals in a whorl, the members of the sepals or petals, how they are arranged within the whorl, that is called as estivation. And there are four types of estivation. One is valvate, second one twisted, third one imbricate, and fourth one is the papillonaceous or vexillary estivation. Valvate nalli all the members are arranged in such a way that they just touch each other, they will not overlap. Twisted nalli all the members will overlap one another at their tip. In case of imbricate estivation, there is no proper arrangement. One whorl may be completely outside and one whorl may be completely inside. Then the other whorls may be overlapping at their ends. Vexillarially, there is a standard petal that is called as the posterior petal. There is a larger one, and there are two lateral petals are called as wing petals, and there are two anterior petals which are fused and they are called as keel. We'll move to question number 36. Match the column 1 with the column 2 with respect to the estivation. Once again, the right answer is the diagram D is correct, which indicates the imbricate estivation. Sorry, the diagram D is the vexillary estivation. A is valvate, B is twisted, C is imbricate, D is vexillary. So all this having correct match for the option 4, that is option D. Move to question number 37. Carpels are fused in the flowers of. Carpels are nothing but the members of corolla. They are fused in the flowers of 1 lotus, 2 tomato, 3 rose, 4 both, 1 and 3. Carpels are fused. That means syncarpous condition. You can see in case of tomato, lotus and rose, you can see apocarpous means carpels are free. Syncarpous you can see in case of tomato. Other than tomato, what are the other examples for syncarpous condition? It is mustard, NCERT example. Let's move to question number 38. Ovary containing the false septum occurs in. Ovary alli false septum ide. That false septum, it is called as what? Replum. It is called as replum. Replum is the false septum. Where you can see the false septum, that is replum. In case of mustard, Brassicaceae family. So which type of placentation they have? They have parietal placentation, where actually there is a unilocular andre onde chamber irudu ovary alli. They are multicarpellary, means many carpels are there, but they are fused, syncarpous conditions, but there is only a single chamber. So it is called as unilocular, but it appears bilocular because of the arrangement of a false septum, that is called as a replum. So for example, idre one second, for example, either. So you can see presence of ovules there at the parietal region. So the placenta, it is called as illi placenta. So it is at the parietal region. Here it is single chamber. The ovary, it is a single chamber, but it appears double due to the arise of a false septum, and this false septum is called as the replum, which helps for dehiscence or dispersal of the seeds. Ovules will later develop into the seeds, and for the rupture of the seeds, there is a formation of a false septum, that is called as replum. And this is, you can see in case of a mustard plant, which is the member of the family Brassicaceae. Followed. So carpels are fused in the ovary containing the false septum, that is called as replum, that is occurs in question number 38, that is in mustard as well as argemone. Both belongs to family Brassicaceae, mustard as well as argemone, which are having parietal placentation. Primrose and dianthus, they are having free central placentation, where you cannot see the false septum. Pisum sativum, it is a P, where you can see the marginal placentation. There also you cannot see the false septum. Coming to question number 39. In dash placentation, the placenta forms a ridge along the ventral suture of the ovary. One axile to basal, the free central for marginal. Yama placentation, the placenta forms a ridge along the ventral suture of the ovary, that is option 4, marginal placentation, that is P is an example. Right? Next question number 40. The stony hard part of the mango represents. The stony hard part of the mango represents. Which is the stony and very hard part of the embryo? It represents dash. Tell me. So that is the endocarp. You have studied the fruit drupe. Drupe. Examples are mango as well as coconut. They have pericarp, the cover. The pericarp is divided into outer epicarp and middle mesocarp and inner endocarp. In case of coconut, in case of mango, the endocarp is hard. In case of mango, the mango seed, the endocarp is hard. That hard and stony endocarp is present. Okay, it is not edible part. So that is the endocarp. Mesocarp andre middle region. Mango dalli epicarp ide, that is sippe, that is the outermost skin. You cannot eat, you will throw it. The mesocarp is the middle part, that is fleshy and juicy, you eat it. And the endocarp is the hard and stony, which you throw, which you will throw out, isn't it? Guarantee. Then in coconut, the mesocarp is fibrous and the endocarp is little bit harder, but you can eat it, correct? And endosperm is the liquid part, siyaladaniru, elaniru. So tender coconut water, that is endosperm, which is liquid. It's a nutritive tissue which gives nourishment to the developing embryo. So the stony hard part of the mango represents the endocarp. It represents the endocarp. So students, you have finished up to question number 40. The rest of the questions we will discuss in our next session. So students, note down all the important points I have written on the board, as well as also take down my lecture notes. So thank you students for watching the video.
Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.